Dear students, today we are going to see boric acid, which is used as food preservative, antiseptic, etc. Now, how to prepare? Preparation properties and uses we are going to see. To start with preparation, boric acid is a very weak acid. That too, monobasic acid. We'll be seeing how can it be monobasic. When borax is treated with sulfuric acid, we'll be getting boric acid. Borax are colmonite. Na2B4O7 is borax. Colmonite is Ca2B6O11. To convert borax into boric acid, we need sulfuric acid. Of course, water is also involved in the reaction. And to convert colmonite into boric acid, we pass sulfur dioxide gas. Of course, aqueous solution, therefore water is also involved in the reaction. What are the products? Here sodium will become sodium sulfate. All the four boron will become four boric acid, 4H3BO3. Here all the calcium will go as calcium bisulfite, HSO3 minus ion. Balance of calcium 2, bisulfite ion 1, therefore CaHSO3 twice. And then of course boric acid we should get. It is for the preparation of boric acid only. All the boron 6 should become 6 boric acid. Then how to balance the equation? Here I said sodium sulfate. So Na2SO4. So Na2SO4 over 2Na, 1 sulfate over 4 boric acid. Therefore, we had 12 hydrogen atoms in the product side. In the reactant side, we should make 12. How can it be? Here we should not suppose to change. Remaining 10. 12 hydrogen out of 12, 2 are here, remaining 10 should be here, therefore 5H2. I think balanced equation, because 7 oxygen and then 5 oxygen, 12 oxygen. Sulfate radical as such in the sulfate radical. Hydrogen 5H2 plus 1, 6H2, 12 hydrogen. Next reaction, 2 calcium, therefore 2. 4SO3 we had, and therefore 4SO2 we should have. 2 into 2, 2CaHSO3 twice, and therefore 4SO2. Remaining we have to balance only hydrogen, because we have balanced boron. So to balance hydrogen, we have 3 into 6, 18, plus 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen. Totally 22, 18 plus 2 into 4, 22. So 22 hydrogen atoms we should make here, therefore 11H2. If I count oxygen atom, I think it will be balanced, because every other thing is balanced. 11 oxygen, 12, 4 into 2, 8. But here we have 2 into 2 into 3, 4 into 3. 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 3, 12. So 12 oxygen atoms in the product side, plus 3 into 6, 18. Totally 30. Whether we had 30, 22 plus 8, 30. Yes, 30 oxygen atom. Balanced equation. So we have prepared a boric acid. Then, regarding its properties, what are the important properties? First and foremost property is acidic nature. What about the acidic nature of boric acid? Even though it has got 3 hydrogen atoms, even though we write it as BOH thrice, it is not a tribasic acid, it is a monobasic acid. That too, the acidic nature is not by the donation of hydrogen ion, but because of the acceptance of hydroxide ion from water. It accepts OH minus ion. to become BOH 4 minus, BOH 4 times minus. When hydroxide ion is taken up by BOH thrice, being electron deficient molecule, we can say OH minus ion is taken up by boric acid to become BOH 4 minus plus H plus. Usually H plus exists as hydronium ion, and therefore it combines with one more molecule of water to become H3O plus. And the consolidated equation I can write like this: when boric acid is with water in aqueous medium, it accepts hydroxide ion to become BOH 4 times minus and hydronium ion plus H plus and H plus get cancelled. So it is a monobasic acid, and just is pernicious. One molecule can furnish one hydronium ion or one H plus, and therefore it is said to be a monobasic acid. That too not because of furnishing proton directly. By accepting OH minus, it furnishes H plus ion. That is acidic nature. It is because of the acidic nature with sodium hydroxide it can form salts. So formation of salt with sodium hydroxide, with sodium hydroxide, will be right. It forms two types of salts. Boric acid with sodium hydroxide gives two types of salt. It is orthoboric acid. H3BO3 can be called as orthoboric acid. We have one more boric acid, HBO2, metaboric acid. And then tetraboric acid, H2B4O7. H2B4O7. Sodium salt of tetraboric acid may be considered as borax. So this HBO2, if it is replaced by sodium, we will be getting sodium metaborate. If it is replaced by sodium, we will be getting tetraboric acid, tetraborate. So both these things we are getting. When boric acid is made to react with sodium hydroxide, it becomes NaBO2 or Na2B4O7. Both those things we are getting, plus H2 of course. When an acid is neutralized by a base, you should get salt and water. The salt sodium metaborate, sodium tetraborate. Both these things we are getting. So how to balance the equation? One boron, no problem. Now we have to balance hydrogen and oxygen. 3 plus 1, 4 hydrogen, therefore 2H2O. I think it is balanced equation, 3 plus 1, 4, balanced equation. If we go in for next one, B4, therefore we need 4. 2 sodium, therefore we need 2. Now I should make only water, 12 plus 2, 14. Therefore, 7H2. 12 hydrogen plus 2, 14, 12 oxygen plus 2, 14 oxygen, 7 plus 7, 14 oxygen. So, balanced equation. When boric acid is neutralized by sodium hydroxide, we get two types of salts, sodium metaborate and sodium tetraborate. Sodium metaborate, sodium tetraborate. And then third reaction with ammonia. Ammonia is let me go into action of heat, so that we will be getting the corresponding acids. 3. Action of heat. When boric acid is heated, the action of heat can be shown in three temperatures: 373 Kelvin, 413 Kelvin, and under red hot. These are the three conditions. At first, you will be getting HBO2 metaboric acid, H2B4O7 tetraboric acid, and finally boron trioxide. Just one molecule, from one molecule we get HBO2 and then water, one water molecule. To get tetraboric acid, 4 boron atoms. Maybe if it is from metaboric acid, 4 HBO2 I can write. From that 1 H2BO4 plus 1 H2O, that's all. when the tetraboric acid H2B4O7, if it is further heated at red hot, you will be getting two molecules of B2O3, because B4, therefore two molecules, again 1H2O. Metaboric acid, tetraboric acid, and then boron trioxide. So that is about action of heat. So we have seen acidic nature monobasic acid with sodium hydroxide, sodium metaborate, sodium tetraborate, action of heat at 373 Kelvin metaboric acid, 413 tetraboric acid, red hot boron trioxide, and then with ammonia. With ammonia slightly at higher temperature, maybe 800 to 1200 Kelvin. With ammonia. When boric acid is made to react with ammonia, H3BO3, NS3, 800 to 1200 Kelvin, boron get combined with nitrogen to become boron nitride. Both of them have valence 3. And remaining hydrogen and oxygen to become water, therefore 3H2O. So with ammonia, boron nitride is formed. And then, the important thing, ethyl borate test we used to say. When boric acid is made to react with ethyl alcohol, in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, with ethyl alcohol, when boric acid is made to react with ethyl alcohol in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Here boric acid can be written as BOH3. 3-ethoxy group. The ethoxy group replaces hydroxy group, that's all. Hydroxy plus hydrogen becomes water. So you'll be getting three water molecules plus BOCH5 thrice. It is said to be ethyl borate. This ethyl borate burns with a green edged flame, and it is used as a test for borate radical, whether we have boric acid or borate radical, BO3 radical. Like here, if we have borate salt, you will be getting borate or BO3, 3- ion, that reacts with ethyl alcohol in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid and forms ethyl borate, and that ethyl borate gives green edged flame. It acts as a test for boric acid or borate. Alright, this ethyl borate, when made to react with sodium hydride, when this ethyl borate or any triethyl borate, I can say, instead of ethyl borate, it can be called as triethyl borate. When this triethyl borate or trialkyl borate is made to react with a metallic hydride like sodium hydride, what is happening with sodium hydride, metallic hydride, the ethyl borate or triethyl borate with sodium hydride, it may be trialkyl borate also, all right, may be any alkyl group, it may be trimethyl or triethyl or some alkyl. When it is made to react with sodium hydride, what is happening, we get a complex salt, Na plus outside the coordination sphere, Na plus, the H minus entering in, BHOC2H5 thrice, we get a complex coordination compound containing 3-ethoxy group and 1-hydrido group and central ion boron. Sodium outside the coordination sphere, Na plus, ethoxy neutral, H minus, and therefore you'll be getting a minus charge. So likewise, you'll be getting a coordination compound. When triethyl borate is made to react with sodium hydride in the presence of tetrahydrofuran. Furan, you may be knowing, it is furan. If the double bond is replaced by the addition of hydrogen CH2, 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 CH2O, it is said to be tetrahydrofuran. You will be getting this type of a complex. And then from boric acid, we may also prepare boron trifluoride. The next reaction, let me rub the preparation. And the next property, sixth one, with calcium fluoride and the sulfuric acid, with the CaF2 and H2SO4. When boric acid, H3BO3, is made to react with calcium fluoride and sulfuric acid, what is happening? We get boron trifluoride, calcium sulfate. We'll be getting calcium sulfate and then water. So this is how the reaction proceeds. Water. So how to balance the equation? We get boron trifluoride, BF3. BF3, it is 2, it is 3. So LCM 6, therefore 2. It should be 2, it should be 3. Very fundamental. And then when calcium combines with sulfate, you will be getting calcium sulfate. 3 calcium, therefore 3 calcium sulfate. 3 sulfate, therefore 3. Totally, 6 plus 6 hydrogen and 6 out. 6 plus 6 hydrogen and 12 hydrogen totally and 6 oxygen, therefore 6H2. That's all. So with the calcium fluoride and sulfuric acid, boric acid becomes boron trifluoride. Finally, reaction with sodium carbonate. With sodium carbonate, it forms salt. Sodium tetraborate, that is borax, we'll be getting. When boric acid is made to react with sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, it forms Na2B4O7. And therefore, when Na2B4O7, sodium tetraborate is nothing but borax. 4 boron, therefore 4. What else you'll be getting? Carbonate naturally should get decomposed into carbon dioxide. Remaining 1 oxygen. Here, 12 out of 12, 7 oxygen atoms are with borax. 1 oxygen atom we have gained from here. Out of 12 oxygen atoms, 12 plus 1, 13 oxygen atoms, 7 went in the form of borax, remaining 6. So 6H2, 12 hydrogen, 6H2, that's all. So that is about chemical properties of boric acid. Boric acid is an important compound as the structure is a layer structure with the BO3, 3 minus unit, borate unit. And it is mainly used in pottery, enamel, making enamel as a pigment, as an antiseptic, eye lotion, food preservative. These are all the common uses of boric acid. And now let me go into the structure of boric acid. Structure of boric acid, where it forms the layer structure. The boric acid molecules are linked among themselves through hydrogen bonds. Boron, oxygen, hydrogen, maybe 120 angle. Likewise, you make 3 such bonds, 120 degrees. Here one oxygen, here one oxygen. Same thing, hydrogen. Here it should go like this. Exactly 3 BOH bonds we made. And then we should have hydrogen bond with the neighboring boric acid molecule. How? The oxygen should make hydrogen bond with the neighboring boric acid. So I should get oxygen here. So naturally a boron. Oxygen. More or less. It is present just opposite, more or less. And if I make hydrogen, the hydrogen can be made like this with 120, and I should make hydrogen like this. Here a hydrogen bond, and then one more boron can be here. It can be with oxygen. Little bigger. A hydrogen bond is made between this. This oxygen, hydrogen. Bond angle 120. And this can be like this. And this can be like this. And we can make a hydrogen bond here. Likewise, I can make one more molecule. And so many such molecules I can create. O. There can be, the oxygen can be bonded with boron. Oxygen likewise. Hydrogen. This hydrogen can make hydrogen bond. So likewise, so many boric acid molecules. We made one boric acid here. Another boric acid we made here. It is one boric acid, it is another boric acid. All right. We made another boric acid here. So likewise, we can make boric acid molecules, and they can be made in the form of sheets. They are linked among themselves through hydrogen bonds. So that is about the structure of boric acid. Here, it is a two-dimensional sheet. It will not be in three-dimension. So many layers we can have. One can slide over the other. Therefore, boric acid is also used as carom board. We may use boric acid. It is a two-dimensional layer consisting of mainly BO3 3- unit. And the hydrogen is bonded with that, of course. So that is about boric acid. Thank you.